You're watching PBS New York.
Welcome to How's He Doing? The show where the black voter takes a frank, honest look at President Obama and asks, how's he doing? You're watching this because it's too early for football, but too late for church. Well, the midterm elections are on Tuesday, and it doesn't look good for the president. Since we last checked, Obama's approval rating has dropped by 5 points to hit a record low of 41%. But even worse than that, the president's approval rating among black voters has dropped 7 points, all the way down to 92%. Joining me to discuss this dip is our unbiased panel. Ronnie Williams is a writer for Ebony Magazine. Natalie Dickerson is a senior editor for Black Voices on the Huffington Post. Denise London is a cultural critic for Vibe. And Kevin Michael Jakes hosts a show called Shaking My Head on Sirius FM's new Mm-mm channel.
Good to be here.
All right, well, the midterms are looking bleak. Republicans are likely going to take the Senate. And many Americans have been disappointed with the president's handling of the Ebola crisis, immigration, and ISIS. So I'm asking, for real, should we have voted for Mitt Romney? Hell no. Come on now. Hey, come on. You heard me. I even said for real that time. I do love a laugh in the morning. But seriously, people don't think that the president is doing enough about Ebola.
Okay, look, one American has died from Ebola. One. Okay, Kim Kardashian has claimed more black victims than Ebola. Come on now.
Yeah, but still, it is scary.
Well, then be safe. White people keep talking about how they're afraid to catch disease while they're kissing their dog on the mouth.
Oh, they love doing that.
I know how you got Ebola. From the pit bull you rescued from the landfill.
Why are people so proud about a dog they got for free? You don't hear me bragging about the cologne I rescued from this magazine.
You don't. You really don't. Mm-mm. Moving on. Many people are saying that Obama wasn't prepared for the rise of ISIS, which seemed to catch the administration by surprise.
You can't blame the president for being distracted. He's got people running into his house.
How are these people getting into the White House so easy? The president of the United States should have better security than Tay Diggs. I mean, run into R. Kelly's yard and see what happens.
Absolutely. Absolutely. All right, let's move on to What Would It Take? Our weekly segment where we ask, what would it take for Barack Obama to lose your support? Would the president lose your support if he radically changed his hairstyle?
Depends on the hairstyle.
A Jerry curl.
He could bring a Jerry curl back. I mean, Ice Cube made some of his best albums with a Jerry curl.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Dreadlocks.
Uh-huh. You mean like clean style dreadlocks, right? Like Larry Fitzgerald?
No, no. I'm talking about three thick, dirty dreadlocks for his entire head.
Oh, no. Haitian style?
Yeah, that's right.
Hell no. Any man over 40 with dreadlocks better have a PhD or his own incense store.
So he loses your vote?
No.
All right, well, next. Sasha and Malia talk back to Barack in public, and he does nothing.
Okay, he probably whoop him after company leaves, right?
He does not whoop them. He does not do anything.
Okay, but he gave them the look, right? Right. I mean, sometimes all you need is the look.
He did not give them the look. He looks down and away.
Well, I mean, they're nice young ladies, so I'm sure whatever they said wasn't that bad.
Barack said, y'all get up to bed now. And they said, shut up, bitch! We watching Scandal.
No, absolutely not.
I'm sorry, you cannot have your kids talk to you that way. You are the president. You need to command respect.
So does he lose your vote?
He does not.
There we go. Well, that's today's show. Join us next time when we ask Ferguson PD, guilty or incredibly guilty? I'm going with incredibly guilty.